Hey, y'all. Hey, let's get into this collective reading for the collective. It has been a minute. Like, I don't even know why time has passed and I just didn't get the nudge to do so. But I got the nudge yesterday and I got the nudge today and I was like, let's get back into it. So let's get back into these collective readings. I love the response that I get from all of my readings, but especially these. I've also gotten some constructive criticism in regards to slowing down, and it's not on purpose. I feel like I just naturally speak a little faster than others. However, when I get a download, there's this energy of excitement that comes through because I'm getting this connection, and then I just have to get it out. So with that being said, I'm going to be more conscious and more aware of the speed. However, you know, you can always slow it down. Slow it down. You can slow it down. Okay. So there's a little button on your screen, little settings button, and it allows you to do that. You have the power and the choice to do that. So if I'm going too fast, do what you got to do. Not my business, not my problem. Okay. All right. So there is a message for the collective, and I am like really excited about it. I feel like spirit was like, get up. Okay. Get harmony. You are able to feel a loving, balanced connection with everything, Ashe. We all are interconnected. I believe we are all energetically connected. And so there's this energy of being one with nature and being one with divine, being one with self, which is so important. And that the harmony that resonates off of your being when you are in alignment, when you are balanced. So Ashe to you for having harmony and or seeking it. Okay. And seeking harmony. What else do we need to know moving in love and life? Okay. Okay. Spirit said it's a lot. Let me teach you. What else do we need to know moving in love and light? In pursuit of harmony or just basking in harmony? What else do we need to know moving in love and light? Ashe to the ancestors. Ashe to the universe. Thank you. Spirit says that there's something that we need to moving in love and light, basking in harmony or in pursuit of harmony. There's this energy of Isis. Okay. Isis, an Egyptian goddess. Yes. This has to do with our past life. So this situation involves your past life memories. Bringing balance involves you dealing with the past, confronting to the past, healing from the past. Some of us are in a space where in order to have harmony, we need to do this. And that is perfectly fine. That's that shadow work, diving into the shadow self, asking yourself those deeper level thinking questions, taking accountability and responsibility for your choices, but also releasing so that you can move forward in love and light. Okay. Your roots upon this planet are strong and deep, and some of the roots have anchored you in past memories from faraway times. These roots have anchored you so deeply, in fact, that you're paralyzed when it comes to moving forward. I've called your attention to this condition so that you may unearth and uproot past memories. Sometimes you bury those memories to shield yourself from psychic pain or embarrassment, so you won't remember those awkward moments when life tested you to the maximum. Reveal those lessons to yourself now, strong sorceress, and move forward with the confidence that you have sage wisdom behind you. So again, this card is asking for you to get a past life regression to gain insight and answers if you're into it. If not, it's not for you. Okay. Just period. Ancient fears from a past life are resurfacing right now. And so when something comes to the surface, regardless of how you feel about it, it's time to deal with it head on. This may bring about anxiety. This may bring about fear. This may bring up hidden enemies, but what's done in the dark comes to the light. It's time to address it. And then it's time to leave it there. You cannot move forward looking backward. Okay. You've known the person you're inquiring about in your past life. Your current situation relates to a childhood issue. Now, just to be clear, Isis, the Egyptian high priestess moon goddess, is regarded as one of the most important ancient deities because of her many functions and her vivid history. She's simultaneously motherly and businesslike, feminine and ultra strong. Is this you? Isis brought her murdered husband Osiris back to life, and they conceived their beloved son Horus, the falcon-headed pharaoh. Unfortunately, Osiris was murdered beyond repair after the conception, and Isis devoted her attention to raising Horus. Isis also convinced the sun god Ra to tell her his secret name that contained vibrational tones that created instant manifestations. Thus, Isis is also known as a goddess of divine magic and alchemy, a magician. You can call upon her for assistance in many areas, including help with past life memories. Ashe to the ancestors, ashe to the universe. All right, so we're moving in harmony. We're seeking balance. We're releasing some of our past life traumas. And what else, Spirit? Queen Nandi. Hey. Thank you, Spirit. We are using our intuition, okay? We are getting grounded. I like that for us as well. Queen Nandi was the mother of a warrior king, Shaka Zulu. His father's royal family first rejected her. They said that she wasn't pregnant and her belly resulted from an Ishaka beetle sting, but Nandi knew her son would be great before he was even born. So Spirit is acknowledging, you already know, when it comes to this situation, seeking harmony and releasing the past, you already know. So take a deep breath and surrender to what you know to be true. Truth doesn't argue with a lie, never. Trust your inner wisdom and guidance. What is your guidance telling you? Put your hands over your third eye center, the center of your forehead, you know where it is, and ask, if I knew what the answer is, what would it be? Then follow your first instinct. The creator and your ancestors connect with you through your intuition. Trust your internal GPS. The nudges, signs, and coincidences are divine guidance. Okay, and I got all the nudges to send this message today. Thank you, Spirit. Slow down. Got it. Got it. Go for a walking meditation. Be present with nature and pay attention. Being present allows you to feel, hear, see, and sense your guidance using all of your senses. Tap into that intuition. It is your internal guide. It is your map. Don't turn away from that of what you hear, because it is literally your higher self talking to you. That's amazing. That's a connection and a conversation that is sacred, that I believe is holy, that I do not believe needs to be ignored. Okay? So as you move forward today, declare and affirm, I am knowing. This is a tarot card reading. You do with the information what you choose. Now we sit back and let the universe do what the universe does.